morning and Jai Jagat children. Children, we are forced to meet this way through virtual class because of obvious reason, Corona pandemic. Children, you know that we are supposed to finish up first 10 chapters in your first comparative physics exam. And today I would like to take up a unit electrostatics, and the article of the electrostatics which I would finish up right today is concept of charge. Children, the concept of electric charge started right in the beginning of civilization, that is in the Stone Age. Human beings' first interaction with the charge was in the form of frictional electricity. When a piece of bone is rubbed against a surface, it starts attracting tiny particles of dust and dry leaves. Not only a piece of bone, a piece of stone, the tools made of wood, when they were also rubbed against different surfaces, they showed same attractive property. Right in the beginning, the conclusion according with regard to the charge was that charge is nothing but it is a form of energy. The concept of charge and energy, they were intermingled. Even today, if you look at your English language, the charge is used, the word charge is used in sense of energy. At times you say, come on, charge up yourself. What does this mean? This simply means you need to increase your energy level. Don't charge at me. That means don't get angry with me. When you are angry, you are extra energetic. So even today, we use charge in sense of energy or energy in sense of charge. Both are. This was the initial conclusion of the charge. Now, charged bodies, right in the beginning of the civilization, they were created by rubbing the surface against various bodies. And all the charged bodies which were created, they showed only two types of behaviors. One was attractive, another was repulsive. On the basis of these two types of behavior, it was concluded then that the charges are of two types, positive charge and negative charge. These positive charges are responsible for attractive behavior and negative charges are responsible for repulsive behavior. Well, development continued in every walk of human activity, so in the science. So, the very first model which came before us with regard to the structure of atom was Dalton's atomic model. Dalton, in his atomic model, very clearly stated that so-called negative charge is in the form of cloud surrounding positive charge which is inside the core of an atom. Again, there were experiments by Rutherford, Neil Bohr and Sommerfeld. And what these experiments stated about an atom is what we know about an atom today. So there is a brief recapitulation of what is the information about atom which is known to all of us. Every atom consists of three elementary particles. Atom itself means something which cannot be cut. So these three elementary particles are electrons, protons and neutrons. Electrons have negative charge. The negative charge which was concluded in the beginning is there with the particles called electrons. The positive charge is there with the particles called protons. Neutrons are neutral. These protons and neutrons together are called nucleons. J.J. Thomson discovered electron, and you all know that the credit of discovery of neutron goes to Chadwick. Rutherford discovered proton. Right? When these particles were discovered, there was a very famous experiment conducted by Millikan. Millikan Waldorf experiment. Millikan, through his revolutionary experiment, could find out the value of the charge over electron or value of charge over proton. That charge which is over proton or electron is called elementary charge. It is smallest value of charge. It is fundamental charge. And this value is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Same is the value of charge over electron, but it is negative. Same is the value of charge over proton, but it is positive. Neutrons have no charge, they are neutral. Now children, let us talk about a neutral atom. A neutral atom consists of same number of protons and same number of electrons. Total positive charge of all the protons and total positive charge of all the electrons, they cancel each other and net charge over an atom is what? Zero. You know, in an atom, this subscript Z is nothing but number of protons, it is also called as atomic number, and this superscript is A, which is called as atomic mass number, and it is also number of nucleons. Number of nucleons, you know, is sum total of protons and neutrons. So in a neutral atom, number of protons is same as number of protons. Therefore, net charge over an atom is what? Zero. A neutral atom creates neutral substances. There were series of developments in the field of nuclear physics. There were various experiments conducted by Giger and Muller. There were Williamson, the scientist who conducted and made his counter. There was beam-based spectrograph, and finally there was binding energy curve. Through binding energy curve, we came to know that the binding energy of proton is 8.5 million electron volt. And we already knew that the binding energy of the electrons in every substance lies in between 0 to 6 electron volt. This binding energy of electron, what is binding energy? Let us first of all clarify that. Binding energy of a particle is the energy with which the particle is bound to its system. Binding energy of electron is 0 to 6 electron volt. That means an electron is bound to an atom with this energy. 0 in case of metals, 1 in case of metalloids, and close to 6 in case of all non-metals. On the other hand, binding energy of proton, which are there inside the nucleus, has an average value of 8.5 million electron volt. It is 85 like unit of energy. If we compare the two energies, the binding energy of electron is 0 as compared to the binding energy of proton, which is 85. 0 and this is 85 like unit. If we compare the two, the binding energy of electron is 0, binding energy of proton is what? Infinite. What does this mean? Since the binding energy of electron is 0, they can easily move in as well as out of an atom. Binding energy of proton is what? Infinite. That means it is practically impossible to detach a proton from nucleus or add a proton to a nucleus. Therefore, electrons are mobile and protons are what? Immobile. They cannot be moved in as well as out, except under very extreme conditions, which exist only during nuclear holocaust or over stars. Now, this is a neutral atom. This neutral atom, when loses an electron, when loses an electron, it creates a cation. And this cation is an atom with one unit of positive charge. This one unit of positive charge. One unit of charge is this elementary charge. So when an atom loses an electron, it creates a cation with one unit of positive charge. When an atom loses two electrons, it creates a cation with two units of positive charge. When an atom loses three electrons, it creates a cation with three units of positive charge. And if an atom loses an electron, it creates cation with n unit of positive charge. And you know this phenomenon is called as oxidation. At the same time, there is another phenomenon which you are familiar with, that is called reduction. If an atom gains an electron, it creates a particle, anion, which is negatively charged particle, and the charge over the particle is one unit of negative charge. If an atom gains two electrons, there would be an anion with two units of negative charge. If an atom gains three electrons, there would be cation with three units of negative charge. And if an atom gains n electrons, it will create a cation with n unit of negative charge. So that's how, through cations and anions, in the form of cations and anions, negative and positive charges are created. So children, our concept of charge, which was initially intermingled with energy, is now completely reversed. There is a U-turn in the explanation of the charge. Initially we said charge is nothing but a form of energy. Now we entirely we reject it completely. The new concept of charge is what? Charge is nothing but excess or deficiency of electrons over a substance. What is charge? Charge is a state. State of what? Excess or deficiency of electron over a substance or an atom as compared to when it is neutral. Neutral means when number of electron is same as number of protons in the atom. Now, right at this stage, since charge, it's since E, electron itself is an elementary particle, it cannot be further subdivided, so is its charge. Therefore, we have another very important concept related with the charge, and that is called as quantization of charge. Quantization of any quantity means that quantity occurs as the cluster of its smallest unit. Like you have studied in biology, number of cells in human body is what? Quantized. Either there would be one cell in the human body, in living cell, or there would be two cells in living cells, or there would be n number of cells, and that n is always an integer. Cell cannot, a cell is the smallest subtle and functional unit of life. Same way is the concept of quantization. Not only here, you will come across quantization of momentum, you will come across various other type of quantization principles later on as you go through your syllabus of class 12. Right now it is quantization of charge. So every value of charge is always a cluster of its smallest quantity, and that smallest quantity is what? E, the elementary charge. And that is what we state as every value of charge is always integral multiple of E, the elementary charge. Q is equal to N E, where N is what? An integer. This N would either be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. It would always be a whole number. It cannot be a fraction, pure or impure. It cannot be 1.2. It cannot be 1.5. It cannot be 2.5. It would always be whole number, but it cannot be any number in between these whole numbers. This is what is quantization of charge. Very, very important. And you are going to have a question about this quantization principle in your first competitive exam.